Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is Azure Friday. I'm here with Tommy Nguyen, and we're talking about Azure billing.
Yes, we are.
I was taking a look at my account. I always log in, check my billing, maybe like once a week, and I look at the, it's like a burn down chart or a prediction of what I'm going to spend, and anytime it looks wrong, I start digging in.
Yeah.
In the past, I used to have to dig around in PDFs, and it kind of was no fun.
Right. And you know, we've been working really hard to make that easier for you so that when you go to the Azure portal, you have all of your billing tools and everything that you need to really understand what charges you're being charged for and how that's attributing to your Azure usage.
Yeah. Before, I think like years ago, 3-4 years ago, it was Excel, CSV files and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But it's a whole active thing. Like you've got some charts up here, but those are active charts you can dig into.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. And we still have those Excel spreadsheets and CSVs
if
people still want to use them. But, you know, we want to make it so that it's easier to really digest this information.
So what are we looking at right here?
Yeah, so I have opened my portal. So it's the Azure portal. And then I'm going to go right in and click on cost management and billing.
Mm-hmm.
So this is going to show you the billing experience that we have. It has a recent billing history chart that would tell you, okay, here's my Azure costs over the past several months. And then when you highlight on each of the different months, it'll tell you the different costs for that month. And so you can really spot anomalies. You can see that, hey, in April, I spent a lot on Azure. And then in as it got into May, my expenses went down. So then you can really say, okay, what did I do different and whether that makes sense for my business or even personal usage.
Yeah. I'm always afraid I'm going to leave a virtual machine on for like, I don't know, like a big one, like a super large that I did for a demo.
Right.
Get on an airplane and then like wake up the next day and discover.
Yeah. Yeah. And we've built tools for you to really be able to track that. Additionally, some of the things that I've heard from customers are, hey, how do I get a copy of my invoice or my bill at the end of the
month? Yeah, exactly.
And that's something that we've made available in the Azure portal. And so I'd really like to, you know, show it and make sure that it's visible and people are aware of this functionality.
Mm-hmm.
So if you go into the invoices experience on the left nav here, and then you select your subscription that you want invoices for. So in my case, I've selected a subscription that has some usage here and some costs. And you can see that there are the past few months I've been using this account, and now there is a link here that I can download the actual PDF.
Nice.
And there's additionally, you can also have this emailed to you monthly, so you don't have to go to the Azure portal and to be able to view those files immediately.
So that'll be an official email, like it'll come from Microsoft.com account,
yes.
And it'll have the PDF attached.
Exactly, yeah.
And
that's
cool.
You can also provide access, so for other folks who you want access accessing cost information, you can provide that to them by using the access to invoice functionality that we've included here as well.
So does that mean that the other devs on my team, depending on their roles, they can't automatically see the money and how much we're spending?
Yes, and then so you can kind of pick out, depending on what roles you want, or which folks can see the pricing and costs of your Azure services and which folks can't.
Mm-hmm. And if there's a problem, if there's a charge mistake or some kind of an error, they would just contact support and they can work that out?
Yes. So if there's an issue, they can file a ticket in the Azure portal and then our team will be able to sort that out for them.
Mm-hmm. And it says there's a little banner at the top that says external services are invoiced separately. What's an external service?
Yeah. So an external service is a third-party marketplace item. And usually these aren't developed by Azure. Are Microsoft, and so you would actually be charged separately for this, and it's not a part of the invoice that we provide in the portal.
Okay.
You can access this by, you can actually see your external services charges by going to a particular subscription that you might have third-party charges on. In this case, I name my account third-party,
or
subscription third-party.
Smart.
And then you can go to external services on the side here, and it'll list out the different third-party services that you are incurring costs on.
Okay, that makes sense. Can you back up one? Because that was a really nice chart. And within that chart was a purple line that said, try Azure cost management. What is cost management?
Yeah, so we have some cost management functionality in the Azure portal right now. But as you know, we just recently purchased Cloudyn, and so we're trying to integrate a lot of their advanced cost management functionality. Meanwhile, we provided cloud in services for free. And so if you click on this link, it'll actually take you to the cloud in experience where you can use different things to monitor your cloud spend and be able to really optimize your cloud.
So until it gets integrated into the Azure portal, then you can log into their portal
immediately. Exactly.
And go ahead and go back there again, because my favorite chart is this green one on the right here.
Yeah.
That thing has saved me like so many times. And what I like about both of these charts and what I like about all the great work you guys are doing in the Azure portal is that I can pin these.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're ever worried about costing money or spending unnecessary money, pin that forecast.
Yes, exactly. You can pin this forecast directly to your dashboard. And then so you just see at any point how much you're spending right now, and then what you're projected to spend at the end of the month.
Absolutely. And there's no surprises, because that forecast gets closer and closer to reality.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're a couple days before the end of the month, you're going to know exactly what you're going to end up spending.
Yes.
And that saved me probably $50 last month, because I had left a virtual machine on.
Right, right. And the goal of billing in general in the Azure portal is really to make you have cost clarity and understand what you're spending, and so that you're not being overly charged every month and not aware of where these charges are coming from.
Mm-hmm. And being able to look at these cost by resource has been super useful, because mm-hmm. I realized that like Azure storage is basically nothing.
Yeah.
It's like totally free.
Yeah. So actually, if you go into cost analysis, there's going to be additional breakdowns for each resource.
Mm-hmm.
So you could say, okay, I have a virtual machine. And which one of my virtual machines am I using the most money on?
Right, and it sorts by cost automatically, so the most expensive is at the top.
Right, exactly. And then you can also filter it down and say, okay, so I have a resource group that I really want to, I'm concerned with costs. And then so I can select that resource group and filter it down so that I can see the total cost for that resource group and what's contributing to that total cost.
That's a really good point. I think that people who may have started with Azure early don't realize how useful resource groups are. But once you start naming something, when you draw a dotted line around all of your computers and name it, then you get the billing insights that you wouldn't. Before, I was just making up silly names for resource groups. I wasn't thinking about it.
Yeah.
But once I name them and say, here's my startup, here's my side hustle, here's my blog, right?
Yeah.
Those things then show up in my bill.
Yeah.
So what kind of stuff is coming for the Azure billing portal coming soon? Because I've noticed you add invoices and cost mm-hmm. analysis.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen the charts, the overview, the ability to pin.
Yeah.
What are you planning for the future?
Right, yeah. So one of the things that we've been focusing on is our enterprise customers. Mm-hmm. They have their own portal, and they're using cost through that portal. And it's really about bringing that functionality so that any type of customer that we have, they can access the same kind of information through the same experience in the Azure portal. So that's something that we're focusing on. The other thing that we're focusing on is bringing budgeting and making sure that you're alerted as you're spending money on Azure services.
Yeah.
So that's something that we've heard a lot from customers and something that we're working on building right now.
Yeah, even just moving it into the portal, which you've done, and having the ability to pin those things, put them all up front where it's not buried anymore. I used to have to log into separate websites that weren't even part of the Azure portal.
Right.
And now it's really integrated in there. And I've built a dashboard that shows HTTP errors mm-hmm. next to dollars spent, so I can really get a sense of what's going on in my system.
Yeah.
It's pretty fantastic. Is this all available now, or are you showing us beta things?
This is all available now. And as I've mentioned, some of the things we're working on, we're hoping to ship quickly. So expect to see some of those things light up pretty fast.
Very cool. Thank you very much, Tommy. I am learning all about billing in the Azure portal here on Azure Friday.